That's fine. $2,000 worth of stuff in it. It's a Joshua tree right there. So yeah, I'm going to pick this car up. Dude is meeting me at 6:30. He gets like a break off work or school or some shit. And he's got 30 minutes to buy the car. As long as it checks out, I'm buying it, driving it back to Arizona. Wish me luck. I just had a giant fucking dog that's like as tall as I am barking at me. So I'm hoping I'm sprinting down this road trying to eat me alive. Alright, what's up, y'all? Finally got the car. It was a fucking adventure. I'm parched as fuck. I'm gonna go get gas, water, snacks, Dutch Bros, so I don't fall asleep on the way home. But I wanted to talk about everything while it's still fresh in my head right now. So I got the car. I'm fucking stoked. It's fucking sick. It's far from perfect, but it's perfect for a traffic car. It's like just shitty enough where if I crash it, I won't be like fucking devastated. But it's sick enough. It fucking like runs smooth, everything looks fucking sick. So I go to buy the car, right? And we talk everything out. I take it on test drive, yada yada. Everything goes pretty smooth. I go to Cash App him, right? I just had this in my head. I was like, is Cash App cool? He's like, yep. So I Cash App him, right? It doesn't go through. I was like, fuck. So then I try Venmo, doesn't go through. Fuck. Then I call my bank. And they're like, yeah, you just can't withdraw that much. So I was like, well, can I do like a money order or something like that? She's like, yeah. All the banks are closed because it's like 7 p.m., right? And so I go to like a grocery store and do a money order. And they can only do 500 per piece, which is 12 money orders for how much I'd be a little, that would be a little bit more. But that's how many money orders I would have to do. So you can do the math, how much I paid for this car. And yeah, so all that, my arm is literally getting tired. It's been a long day. I've been up since 5. But, yeah, so I'm about to drive this thing fucking home like a psychopath. But it's honestly so fucking sick. I'm stoked. But finally, fucking PayPal worked. Thank God for PayPal. So I don't have to, I would have had to, like, get a hotel and go to the bank early in the morning. And then I'd have to drive home during the day while it's, like, 100 degrees out. So this is much more ideal. But, yeah, this is the car. Fucking sick. The ISO is up like crazy because there's literally no light here. But 92 E36 got all kind of goodies. It's got some angle mods, solid shifter, M3 bumper, click tuning fenders, AC removed, no radio. It's got a bucket seat, both bucket seats, a bunch of weight reduction stuff, 3.9 diff. So this thing fucking moves. There's a car coming. Hopefully they don't fucking kill me. It's got some sick wheels on it. Oh yeah, I'm all good. Thank you though. All
right, man.
Thank you so much. Some good Samaritans making sure I'm all right. Windows don't roll up either, so this will be real fun on the highway. It's straight piped. But yeah, I'm gonna go get some Dutch Bros, some gas, some water. Make sure I don't die on the way home. Like 5 minutes now, I've gotten like 3 fucking compliments already. People just freaking out. Alright, so basically this shit's pretty sketch, but definitely doable. I have 4 more hours. Trying to get gas, drink a bang, so I don't fall asleep. Dude in the gas station said I got muscles. So how long you spend in the gym? 2 hours a day. I'm literally just gonna chug this shit because I have no cup holder and I'm like death gripping the wheel so I don't fucking die. So far, I don't think I'm gonna be able to sleep tonight. It's 300 milligram caffeine right here. Car's running good though. It had like a super loud exhaust. I think it was just banging on the frame rail and it's so loud and it just randomly stopped on the highway. So, God bless for that. Actually, we're not getting gas because my debit card won't work and I don't want to go to the cashier because I filled up like literally 20 minutes ago, so probably just going to end up wasting money. So I'll wait a little longer, hopefully I don't get stranded in the desert. Another pit stop, we made like probably 30, 45 minutes of progress. The loud like whiplash noise from the back, I think it might be the exhaust, but it's a different noise than before. It's kind of freaking me out. I'm going to check it out, get gas for real this time. And might like rest my eyes for 10 minutes because I'm fucking like blinking fast because the fucking, it's just constant wind in my fucking face. I think I might have figured out the problem. But I'm not sure. Fuck me. That's a little ratchet. I also had, I don't know why, but some dude on a motorcycle just rode past me. I don't know what the fuck I did. I'm not even switching lanes. Like I'm just driving slow in the right hand lane, so I don't fucking know, but I think it's fine. Alright, so we take another break right next to the highway, so it might be hard to hear. It's been like another hour. I'm getting tired. Driving's fucking boring. I'm kinda getting in the groove. I got headphones on, listening to music. Fucking back hurts. That's pretty much it. Oh, hopefully this guy's okay. I was like on the side of the highway and there's a semi truck literally just like in like flames. Like it was like a giant bonfire. Like I could feel the heat. I was in the far left lane. I could feel the heat. So hopefully that dude's chilling. That was fucking kind of horrific looking. It's like some shit from a movie. Yeah. I think we got like 3 more hours. Gonna take a little 10 minute break. It's 12:12. We'll get back on the road. I realized that the reason the dude on the motorcycle was probably very mad at me is because my exhaust literally scrapes the ground whenever I go over a bump and like shoots sparks. So he probably got fucking sparked up. So, fuck, I'm sorry, man. But, I mean, there's not much I can do about it right now. So, just gonna have to watch out, bro. Alright, so I'm finally starting to get back on a bit of a roll here. The sun is coming up. Drop my other car key somewhere. Gas is like a dollar cheaper here. More than a dollar. So at one point I was like literally driving and it was still pitch black out and I was 100% certain I was about to fall asleep. Like I was like freaking out and it was in the middle of nowhere too, so there's nowhere to go. So I ended up pulling over at this gas station and I don't like sleeping in like public in general in my car just because of fucking weirdos. And windows, so I was like super nervous. But like, you could tell I was like so fucking tired, because I would like lay my head down for like 1 second and I'd be out. So I like pulled to the side of this fucking gas station where like nobody could really see me that well. And I literally never slept, because every time I would start to fall asleep, I would like fucking freak out. I'm like, somebody's gonna come kill me. But I literally did that like 12 times, and then by the time I did that, I like was like well rested enough to start driving. And then I got here, that's probably like an hour and a half ago. We have 50 more miles to go, which is probably like an hour till Phoenix. So yeah, we're grabbing gas. Just filled her up to the top. This should get us home safe and sound. Car has officially made it home. Looks pretty good in the driveway. That was a fucking awful drive. Like, that was the worst drive ever. I took a break like every hour because like my back hurts. Fucking exhaust is falling off. I feel like everybody's staring at me. They're shooting sparks at people. But we made it safe. I didn't die. And I think I might do something special. If you waited till the end of the video, and since I didn't die, still alive to tell the story, I'll do a little something fun later. But yeah, made it one piece besides the exhaust. Boom. So I'm about to see if I can fix up this exhaust problem so that I can actually drive the car, because I want to take everyone I know on a ride so and get their reactions. So let's see if we can fix this shit. There, we got a lick up to E36 car drag points. Since I'm such a BMW noob, I don't want to fucking just wrinkle my shit. Temporary solution acquired. Hopefully the car doesn't catch on fire. And if it does, I have a fire extinguisher. It came with the car, so fuck it.